Good morning, girls. In today's computer network class, we are going to learn about the reference models. In the previous class, we studied about the network software. Okay. In this class, we are going to study about the OSI reference model, TCP/IP reference model, and the other models which are used in this Tannenbaum author book. Okay. OSI reference model. What is this OSI means? Open system interconnection. Actually, this OSI reference model will be used to transfer the data from one computer to another computer. Okay. So when you are transferring the data through network, how this model is going to help to transfer the data? That is only we are going to study here. Okay. So there are 7 layers are involved in this transmission work. Okay, what are the 7 layers? Physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and application layer. The acronym of the 7 layers I have given there, that is, please do not throw sausage pizza away. That is the easy way to remember all the 7 layers. Okay, P for please, like that you can memorize that 7 layers. Okay, so these 7 layers, each one will do different kind of work. That is only the first slide I have given the principles for the 7 layers. That means each layer is created for different abstraction. Abstraction is nothing but idea. So each layer is created for a specific purpose. And this layer will perform well-defined function, which is nothing but if it is a physical layer that is having some special kind of work, so that will be defined, okay, through the internet standard protocols. Okay, there are some set of rules to transfer the data from one place to another place, that is called as protocol. That international standard protocols will be used in this each layer. This model is also called as ISO or OSI reference model because it deals with connecting open systems. So that only we are calling this system as, that means this model as OSI reference model. You can see the picture. This picture will give you clear information about the model. This is a very important picture. When you are getting this question, you must draw this picture, then only you have to explain one by one. It's a very, very important question. Without this question, there is no computer network question paper at all. Okay. Okay. So there are 7 layers I told you. In the left side, you can see the layers. In the right side, you can see the name of the unit, how the data is going to be exchanged between the layers. See, there are 2 hosts are going to be used when you are transmitting the work, host A and host B. From host A to host B, when the data is transferred in this physical layer, it will be transferred in the form of raw bits. Okay, for example, zeros and ones, that we will see in detail in the physical layer. And in the data link layer, it will be converted as a frame. In the network layer, it will be in the form of packet, like that. For each layer, there will be the data unit. According to that, it will be going to transfer the data. Okay. So this picture is a very important picture. If you memorize this picture, you can write the remaining points easily. Okay. Physical layer. This is the bottom of the OSI layer. This will transmit raw bits from one computer to another computer. See, for example, you are going to chat with your friend or you are going to send a particular file to your friend. Everything is going to be performed through network. Okay. So when you are transferring a file, you take an example that you are going to transfer a file. When you are transferring the file, what this physical layer will do? What it will do? It will transmits the raw bits from one computer to another computer. Whatever data you are storing it in the system will be in the form of zeros and ones. Okay. So that is only is going to be transferred through this physical layer. And it will tell how the cable is attached to the network adapter. okay, that will also define by this physical layer. And if there is any issues with this conversions or data formats like zeros and ones, in that if there is any issues, it can handle, okay, and it can handle the design issues about the mechanical, means the hubs which you are going to connect, the cables which you are going to connect, is there any procedural interfaces, all those issues can be handled by this physical layer. So clear about this physical layer, it is going to transmit the raw bits, okay, it will tell what kind of cable, how it can be attached with the computer, and it will be dealing the issues like zeros and ones conversions and mechanical and electrical procedural interfaces. The next layer is the data link layer. Data link layer, what it will do? Already the physical layer divided the data, that means zeros and ones, raw bits, okay, that has been transferred. Here what the data link layer has to do? It has to divide the data in the form of frames. That is only the first point. Package is raw bits from the physical layer into the frames. The data is in the form of raw bits. It is going to be divided in the form of frames. Once it has been divided, it is providing the reliable transmission for the frames. You could see the picture. This picture will be telling about how this frame is going to be transferred from one place to another place. Okay. So it is in the form of frame footer, and the data is there, and the header of the frame is there, and it is having the source address and the destination address. Through this data, the frame is going to be moved from one place to another, and it will be waiting for an acknowledgement from the receiving computer. When once the frame has been received the other end, the other system has to provide an acknowledgement to the source system. Then only it can identify that the frame has been received properly in the other end. If it is not received, it has to retransmit the frames. Okay. So how it can retransmit? It will wait for an acknowledgement for a particular time. If it is not receiving the acknowledgement, again it will retransmit the frame. This is the work of the data link layer. So clear about this data link layer. Next is the network layer. What this network layer will do? It will look after the address of the source machine to the destination machine. That means manages the addressing, routing of data within the subnet. The data which you are going to send could have been in near to your system, or it could be far away from your system. So what the network layer has to do? It has to find out the address, and it has to manage the routing, how this particular packet has to be forwarded to that destination computer. That is only the second point. It determine how the packets are routed from source to the destination computer. And the next one, while the data has been transmitted in the network layer, it has to identify whether there is any traffic problems or something. If there is any traffic problems, all those things has to be handled by this network layer. According to that, it has to receive the receiver end. That is only the third point. It manages the traffic problems such as switching, routing, controlling the congestion of the data packets. Switching means from one host to the other host, there could be many subnets. So from one subnet to the other subnet, how it can be switched? What kind of route can be used to transfer the data? And congestion means where the data which you are sending, it can be in a fast manner, but the receiver end, the machine cannot reach at that particular time. It cannot receive that particular time. So that could be the congestion of data packets. So that should also be handled by this network layer. It is having different mechanism to handle all those kinds of issues. And then it has to start a particular, when it is going to start a particular package, it has to find out the load, network load of that particular data which it is receiving in the receiver end. According to that, it has to determine the route, then only it has to forward the packet to that particular route. Clear? So till now we studied three layers. Do you remember what are the three layers we studied? Yes, first one is the physical layer. What is the work of the physical layer? Conversion of the raw bits. That means it is going to be in the form of zeros and ones. Okay, that is the work of the that raw bits are going to be transmitted. In the data link layer, what it is going to do? It is going to convert all those raw bits in the form of packets, and in the network layer, it is going to be transmitted through a particular path. In this transport layer, what it will do, according to the path it has been chosen, it is going to check whether it is a small message or long message. If it is going to be a long message, it is again going to be repacked. Okay, so according to that, it is going to be divided into small packets. After that, once it is received at the receiver end, reassemble that packets into the correct order to receive the original message. And it is going to handle the error recognition and recovery. If there is any mistakes while you are transmitting the data, some data could have been missed. What kind of data is missed? How it can be recovered? All those things are going to be handled by this transport layer. And this transport layer will receive that acknowledgement for the packet delivery also. If it is not receiving the acknowledgement, it has to resend the packet. The host has to resend the packet. It is a true end-to-end layer, which means if it is not receiving the acknowledgement, again it has to send it. That is only you could see in the picture. Okay, it is going to deliver across the network connections like TCP or something. If any error is going to be missed, it has to be recovered. While it is transmitting the data, if there is a lot of flow is there, means that could be controlled. And if it is not received properly, retransmission has to be done. That is only given in the picture. So that is the work of the transport layer. Here we are going to see the difference between network layer and the transport layer. It's a very, very important question. Okay, so already we studied network layer and also the transport layer. What are the differences? There are three main differences we are studying here. The first one is the, what is the main work of the network layer? It has to deliver the packets from source to the destination. Transport layer, what it has to do? It is the responsible layer to deliver the packet. Okay, to deliver the entire message. Okay, that is the first point. In the second point, it provides connection services like flow control, error control, packet sequence control. If there is any problem, it has to be handled by the network layer. Whereas in the transport layer, either it can use any connection oriented thing or connectionless services. Any kind of service it can use to transfer the data from one host to the another host. And it translates the logical network address into the physical machine address. Means, since it is a network layer, it is responsible for delivering the packets. Transport layer is responsible for transporting the message. If the message is going to be big message, it is going to divide it into small packets. Again, it has to be reassembled at the other end. That is the work of the transport layer. So these are the three main differences of the network layer and the transport layer. Next is the session layer. What the session layer will do? While it is transmitting the data, it allows the users on different machines to establish the sessions between them. Okay, how it can make a session? By using this services. What are the services? Dialog control, token management, synchronization. Dialog control means when the machines are communicating with each other, it has to keep track of that which has been transmitted, which has to transmit. That is only keeping track of whose turn to transmit. Okay. Next one is token management. Token management means when it is transferred between two parties, based on this, it can see that one by one it has to transfer the data. That means simultaneously it has to transfer the data. It will avoid the critical operations. Next one is the synchronization, which is checkpointing that when it is going to be the long transmission, it has to allow which has to be transmitted next. If it is any problem or something, where the crash has been occurred, how it can be recovered. All those things has to be maintained by using these kinds of services in the session layer. You could see in the picture about this session layer clearly. Okay, when there are 4 or 5 paths between transmitting, how that particular path can be opened to transfer that particular packet. Clear? Next one is the presentation layer. This layer is going to present the message in the other host. Okay, so it is going to maintain the information about the syntax and semantics of the information which is going to be transmitted. So it is deal with the data representation on different mechanisms. Okay, so different machines will have different configurations. According to that, the data which it has been received, how it should be presented, that is going to be handled by this presentation layer. Next one is the application layer. This layer is having lot of protocols which are needed by the users to transfer the data, to supply the network services. Some of the protocols which are used here is, it can be a HTTP. That means if you are going to require a particular page from a Google, you will be using HTTP protocol. When you are transferring a file, you will be using FTP, that is file transfer protocol. If you are going to look at the mail or you are going to send the mail, you could have used this SMTP protocol, simple mail transfer protocol, point to point. Okay, and RSS, if you are going to have any news or something, that RSS protocol will be used. So these are all the different protocols which are used in the application layer according to the usage of the user. Okay, according to the requirement of the user. So these are all the 7 layers of the OSI model. So what is the acronym? Please do not throw the sausage pizza away. Okay, that means 7 layers will be in this form of acronym. According to that, you can remember it, and just you understand according to the name of the layer, you understand the points, then you write. It is a very, very, very important question. Okay.